Hello, this is Ann Sandler with Stitch Supply, and I am here to show you some tips and tricks with Sewing the Village. So if you're here, you probably have joined the Sew Along Sewing a Village on Instagram. Thank you for doing so. The response has been amazing. With that response, I've also had a lot of questions coming my way, so I want to help you out and see if I can give you some tips on sewing all of these houses. We have 132 of these fellas to sew. To sew the homes, we have 7 main pieces. The bottom part is pretty simple. I'm not going to tell you the measurements. They are written in the pattern by Carrie Nelson, and respect for pattern designers, you need to purchase the pattern to follow along. But the bottom of the house is simply sewing the door to the window above, and to the two sides. Which way you press the seams does not matter. It looks a little odd when it's laying here because the two middle pieces seem so much longer, and that's simply because making room for the seam allowance there. And then we have the roof and the two background pieces. In my case, are low volumes, and low volume means that it just reads white or reads light. So mine will be all different scrappy backgrounds. So this is a finished block, and our goal with the roof, and that's what we're going to focus on next. I'm going to show you how to paper piece it and how to traditional piecing as the directions in the pattern call for. But our goal is to have a quarter inch where the roof meets the edge, about a quarter inch on each side, and then about a quarter inch from the top before the white, because once we sew this to the neighboring house next door, that's gonna go away in our quarter inch seam allowance. So if our roof were to go right now all the way to the end, it would be cut off when we sew our homes together. All right, let's get started. I'm gonna start off with the traditional piecing per the directions to make the roof, which is basically a flying geese. So for this, you need the roof itself and two side pieces. And for the next step, you simply sew on one of the sides. It doesn't matter which side you do first. And when I'm lining them up right sides together, I like to line up the bottom of the roof with the bottom of one of the triangle pieces. This way, when you press it out, you have a lot of room up there, and that will help us later with trimming. So after you sew your quarter inch seam allowance, press it open so that the seam will go up towards the sky piece. And then you have a choice at this point. If you want to cut off this little part with a scissors or rotary cutter, you're welcome to. If you want to leave it on, we'll trim it off later. After you sew one side on, you're simply going to do the same sewing the other side. One tip I do have for you is, because our roofs are typically darker than our background pieces, when you're lining up the two pieces here, when you're lining up this white triangle, have it hang out. I'm pretty generous on this one, but if you have it a little bit bigger or further over than your blue, when you fold it back over, none of the blue will show and you won't have that shadowing in the background. Okay, so then sew on the second side, like that. Again, quarter inch seam allowance. When we get done, we have a pretty wonky roof, and that's a good thing, actually. Carrie, the pattern designer, was really generous with her measurements, and I love that because it gives us space to make a nice clean trim. So you have two options. You can use your traditional ruler or the flying geese block lock ruler. Both of them work. If I were to do this one, I would trim it like the directions say and just line it up on the ruler. Or here I have some washi tape added to my ruler. This is when I was fussy cutting the doors. I could center the image in there. When we trim it, our goal is that the corners of the roof will line up perfectly here, right at the corner. So the background and the roof will line up right at the edge. And then we'll have about a quarter inch at the top. Okay, and I'm gonna show you the flying geese block lock ruler. It has ridges in it so that when you set it down on your, your mat, it locks into place. It's very important that we press the seams up towards the sky so that the ruler can lock in, but it doesn't move around, it sticks right there. So when we're trimming, we just simply rotate our mat, if you have a rotating mat, otherwise you just scooch it around. This is a really handy dandy one that Fiskars has made. It's about 8 inches round. Oops, did cut all the way through there. There we go. And so now we have it trimmed right to sizes we need it. So that is the traditional way. I'm gonna set these aside and I'm going to show you how to paper piece. It's another option. For this, the tools that I have, let me get my stuff straight here. This is a template that I created, and it's available for free download at stitchsupply.com under our little Sewing a Village tab. It's under there. Print this off at 100% or actual size. Make sure that you don't shrink or enlarge it because we want it to fit on the base of our house. There's a 1-inch block here. After you print one of them, just go ahead and line it up and measure that block to make sure it's still an inch. All right, and then after you've got it printed off, here's one. You just simply cut with a paper scissors around the edge, really rough. It does not have to be perfect at all because we're gonna trim it again later. But you're gonna cut it, eventually we'll cut it on the dotted line around the edge. So the other tool that is really helpful is called an add a quarter ruler. I'll show you how to use that in 1 second. So I have my paper piecing template and then my rose cut pieces cut just how she told us to do it in the pattern. You can, if there, this one is actually a little bit bigger because I just cut a charm square in half diagonal and then I got my two pieces. So let's talk about paper piecing. If you're new to paper piecing, this is a great way to start. They are numbered. We have them numbered 1, 2, 3. All paper piecing templates are numbered and you want to put your fabric down in that order. For us, the main thing is to put the number 1 down first. 2 and 3 could be switched around and it wouldn't be that big of a deal. So the printed side is actually the side we're going to sew on. The back of the paper is where we're going to place our fabric. So the back of the paper, the back of the fabric go together. Back of the paper, back of the fabric. So I'm simply placing my triangle in the center. And if you hold it up to the light, it helps to see where the fabric is. Just simply in the center. We've got, again, Carrie was so great and generous with the cuts of the fabric. It gives us a lot of wiggle room. So I like to use the flathead pins for this. If you choose to pin it, because then you can, when you sew over it, you don't have a bump. So I have my first piece down. I'm going to put on my low volume, or my background pieces. With these, we want to, number two's over here, fabric will be right sides together now, and you just line up the edge of the red and the white, the background and the roof together. Be careful with this part, and as with the traditional piecing method, when you cut on the diagonal, you've created a bias, and the bias of the fabric really stretches a lot, whereas the straight edges don't stretch at all. One thing that you can do when you're ironing it at the beginning is to spray starch it. That helps to keep that from stretching as much. So I like to place your fabric right on top there, and I just hold it for this next step. And so I'll take it over the machine. I have a straight stitch on, and I have reduced the seam allowance down to 1.5. So I'm going to sew quick, and then I'll show you what I did here. So I have sewn from the corner, and you can go off of the edge of the paper, it doesn't matter. I backstitched. Please backstitch, it'll help us a lot easier, a lot more when we're tearing off the paper. And I sewed all the way to the point of the geese and backstitched again. At this point, what you do is you fold your paper back on that seam line. Your add a quarter ruler has a little ledge on it, a little lip. Hook that on the edge of your paper. And then you can simply take your rotary cutter and cut that off. Now we have a nice quarter inch seam allowance there. And after you cut that off, bring it over and iron. And it's really important to iron with both the traditional way and the paper piecing way after each step so that the fabric doesn't bunch up on you. I'm gonna take my pin out now. And we're gonna do the same thing with the other sides. Fabric is right sides together, lining up the red and the white. And I'm gonna sew just as I did before. Fold back the paper, put the quarter inch ruler on there, and cut that off. And then bring background fabric up. It's really handy to have the iron right next to you because you iron so much. Okay, now what we want to do is trim our flying geese. So we're gonna cut right on the dotted line that goes around the edge. I just like to take a regular ruler for this part and just simply trim it all the way around four sides. I have one here that's already trimmed. So when you get done with this point, you have a choice. Some people like to leave the paper on, some people take it off before this next step. So you can, if you choose to leave it on, line it up with your house piece and then simply sew down that black line, and that line is at a quarter inch over. Or you can take off your paper. And to take off the paper, since you backstitched at each end, you'll simply just tear it off and toss it. Simple as that. There's one other thing I want to show you here with the paper piecing way. I've created this little house and I wanted to put on a roof that has a directional print. If you were to cut a square in half per the directions, if you didn't cut it on point, then your images would be sideways. So I cut this one out, my butterflies, I cut them out the same size. It was the size scrap I had, so it's a little bigger, it's okay, than the piece, and just centered my butterflies how I wanted them. Get out my mat here again. And since it's such a large piece, what you do is the add a quarter ruler has a slant on the edge. You can use that to fold the paper back. So I line up the ruler with the edge, the line of the paper, and fold it back. And then you flip the ruler over and use that lip again to cut off the extra. That'd probably be a good piece for a chimney. And then you can see here, you can just move on like with you did with the other pieces. It's all ready to go. And sew it on. And I think that covers everything, you guys, for today. If you have more questions or you're working on your village and you get stuck, don't hesitate to contact me. It's great. Instagram messages, I try to go in and read daily. You can tag me, you know, in your post and I can answer it right there. And you can even drop me an email at ann@stitchsupplyco.com and I'm happy to answer that way too. Thanks for joining along, you guys. Have a great day.